objections and questions raised by my beloved and learned brother, Brother Imran. First of all, I would make a note that there are, according to Brother Imran, there are difficult passages, there are unclean words, there are, I think he is so reverent, not to use that word, but almost like a pornographic language. He was so reverent that he didn't use that word, but some dirty stories and dirty words used in the Bible. So this cannot be the word of God. That's what he says. Firstly, I would explain that the law was given almost 400 years after the so-called sin of incest, act of incest was committed. At the time of Lot and his daughters, it was 2,000 years before Christ, and it was 500 years before Moses. The Bible tells us, when the law was not given, sin will not be attributed, and there will be no sin. Sin will not be charged against. A man cannot be charged as committing sin where there was no law, because there must be the law. And when you break the law, it is a sin. And the law came 500 years after Lot's incident and 400 years after the Jude and his daughter-in-law's incident. And the second thing is, the Bible doesn't commend it. The Bible doesn't recommend it. The Bible doesn't appreciate it. The Bible doesn't say it is a good thing and you do it. The Bible only records the sin and wrong things committed by those people. What is the lesson, he said, Brother Imran has asked me. The lesson is that God is so impartial that he records the sin of even his prophets. That is a lesson for me. I am a servant of God. I left my job in ECIL. I have been serving the Lord, depending upon him for all my financial needs for 26 years. I have built up more than 350 churches. People consider me as a great servant of Jesus Christ, a theologian, so many things. But if I commit a sin in my secret life, the Lord records it. And on the day of judgment, that will come out. That is the lesson. So the Bible doesn't appreciate or recommend or commend or those fill the incidents. It only is to create a fear in us. If God is speaking so openly about the sin of Lot, Lot's daughters, sin of Judah, and also sin of Noah and other things, sin of David the prophet, if the Lord is not concealing the sin of David or other prophets, he will not hide my sin also. So that is the lesson. And one more thing, bastard. That word means illegitimate children. And that word is used to describe the spiritual stature, spiritual condition of the nation of Israel. Because if a child is born out of the legitimate relationship of holy wedlock, a child is illegitimately conceived in the mother's womb, he will resemble not his father, he will resemble like the neighbor. Padosi ka jaisa dikhta hai ladka. This child doesn't look like the father, so-called father. He carries the name of the father, but looks like the padosi, the neighbor. So, the people of Israel were taking the name of Jehovah, but behaving like Shaitan. They had all the bad qualities of Shaitan, people of Israel, But they say, we are the children of Jehovah. If you are my children, you should be thinking and talking and behaving like me. You say yourself that you are my children, but you behave like the devil. So you are illegitimate children. That is the reason God used that word. And whatever the word God uses, there's a metaphorical meaning to it. There's a metaphorical meaning. So that is the thing. And thirdly, I know all the Muslim arguments, and my brother Imran knows all the Christian arguments. I know what he's going to say, and he knows what I'm going to say. So rightly, when the IREF has printed the publicity for this debate discussion, they said it is edutainment, a wisely coined word, educative and entertainment. I think you wrote it, isn't it? So it educates us and also entertains us. So it is, I love my brother, I know what he's going to say, and he knows what I'm going to say. None of us is so anadi, utna masum nahi hai. So brother Imran, after hearing him, I love him more. So, brothers, one thing I will tell you. There is a notion. How many minutes, brother? 2 minutes? 3 minutes? Five?
6.5 minutes.
Six. Oh, thank you. I have a lot of time. So there is a notion in the Islamic community. Actually, because I have little more time than needed, I would say, Islamic culture pe main to fida hoon. Thank you. Main to Hyderabadi hoon bhai. I'm a man from Hyderabad. And there are so many good things in Islam. And I'm frank enough to say, and even my Christian brothers and sisters have to learn many things from Islamic culture, because many important lessons is maintaining a healthy distance between the women and men. That's very good. That's something to be learned from Islam. And jo kuch bhi seekhna hai, hum seekhne ke liye tayar hai. As my brother Mansoor has introduced me, I am always able to teach and willing to learn. A good teacher is an ever learner. A good teacher is always a learner. And there is only one teacher who never needs to learn. He is God. God always teaches. He never learns. He is only fit up to God, not any human being. We must always be open-minded to learn. And I am happy. I am learning so many things here also. So that enriches my spiritual life. There is a notion in Islam, or my Muslim brothers and sisters, that though the Quran tells us to believe in the scriptures given in the olden times, though the glorious Quran tells us to respect and honor the Torah and Zabur, and other Old Testament scriptures. Unfortunately, those scriptures are not available now. The scriptures have been corrupted. They have been changed. So that is the notion. So, agar available hai nahi to kaise yakin karenge, kaise follow karenge? If the scriptures are not available, if they are changed, or there is another doctrine of abrogation, if they have been changed and replaced, how can we follow that scriptures? To me, the word Allah, I enjoyed the recitation of the name Allah musically when I came and sat down here. It was being played. It was creating a very solemn atmosphere. It's very good. When you recite the name Allah, it reminds me the God of the Bible, because the description is so similar. So similar.
Thank you.
5 minutes? Thank you. the description of Allah as the one and only true God, who knows all, who is the creator of the universe, protector of the universe. All these descriptions, they match very well with Jehovah also. So, the name Allah reminds me of a great God. And as I have great reverence for this God, I cannot believe that God could not protect His word. God Almighty is more than able to protect His word. And God actually promised in the glorious Quran that He will protect the holy scriptures given to the earlier prophets. Surah number 15:9, God promises. Surah number 15, verse 9 in the glorious Quran, God says, nobody can change my words. And almost I can give you 10 more references. God says, my words are eternal. No one can change. No one can change. No one can change. I protect the reminder. The word reminder is actually in Arabic, zikr. That is the other name of the Pentateuch, Torah. Whatever was given to Moses, Allah says, I have protected it. And the great God, if He is unable to protect His own word, how will He protect the universe? How will He protect my tiny life? So, to give due respects to the great God, Allah, we have to believe that the same scriptures are still protected because Allah says, no one can change my word. Because Allah has given the earlier scriptures, He protected the scriptures, and through the final testament, so-called, we believe, in the Quran, He says, O Muhammad, O Muslims, everybody, turn to the olden scriptures and believe them. Once again, I reiterate my faith that Bible is the true word of God. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Again, Pastor O'Fir have concluded his session 2.5 minutes earlier. Now I request Brother Imran to give his presentation for 15 minutes. Brother Imran.
Alhamdulillah, wahda, wa salatu wa salamu ala malla nabi abada. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rabbish rahli sadri wa yassir li amri. Wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Respected sir said that he loves me. I hope it's metaphorical. Otherwise, I can't love sir. I can respect him. I can't love him. Because you see, the problem comes only when the choice of word is wrong. So what I believe is, if Allah has to speak anything, the choice of word should be ultimate. It should not corrupt your mind. It should not give a wrong image in your mind. And as I told, sir said that I know about the future. Wallah, I don't know. I don't know whether sir will live or die in the next moment. I don't know whether I will live or die. I don't know. How can I know what sir is going to say later? I don't know about it. Only Allah knows. Then sir gave a very good explanation. But sir, an explanation is never an evidence. Explanations can be very beautiful. But it is not an established fact unless there are proofs, authentic sources to establish it that cannot be countered later. So you give very beautiful explanations. But you know, Allah help me that I said something so confidently because I had the truth, not because I knew about the future. I said so confidently that sir cannot give a single reference from the Bible to prove that the cases of incest mentioned are a doctrine or a teaching to righteousness or a correction or a rebuke. He gave an explanation, but he did not quote a single verse from the Bible for those cases to give a proof that it is a correction. Good explanation, sis. Then sir said, why should we debate? Sir, the debate is because I do not believe the Bible to be the word of God. It's very good. Alhamdulillah, if you believe Quran to be the word of God, ahlan wa sahlan, I will invite you to come forward. Read the shahada, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Bible, wallah, by God, I don't believe it to be the word of God. Then the sir said, Quran says, believe in the Bible. This is a Sahih International Quran. Thank you very much, sir, for appreciating the Muslim attitude. This Quran has been translated by three women, being officially printed from Saudi Arabia, considered to be the most conservative country. Officially printed from there, mashallah. We do not have a single Bible translated by the women yet. At least, I will discount the statement a little. At least, that is commonly used. Most commonly used. I would like to give two translations. One is in Telugu. Might be sir's mother tongue is Telugu. One in Telugu and the other one in English. So that sir is convenient by reading both the translations. And I challenge you to show me one ayat from the Quran where it says, believe in the Bible. And I give you another challenge. Show me from any Bible of the world, the word Bible. The word Bible is not there in the Bible. The word Bible is not there. You know, in Deccan Chronicle, when I was in my school days, there was a column, believe it or not. And if I am the publisher, I will put this, that the word Bible does not occur in the Bible. For one single time, in any Bible of the world. And the word Bible, I don't know whether sir knows about it or not. If he doesn't know, he said he will show me. I give him a lifetime challenge to show it. And yes, sir, alhamdulillah, we are friends after all. We'll again have another meeting, mashallah, no problem. Only I will arrange the meeting for you to show the word. Sir, the word Bible, do you know when was it coined? When was the word Bible used for the first time? It was used 400 years after the Quran was revealed. How can the Quran have the word Bible in it? For the first time, the word Bible was used almost four centuries after the revelation of the Quran. Yes, I agree.